Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to give you tips on how to sell custom designs or personalized digital files on Etsy. And I also have another Etsy video on how to create a digital download shop, and I'll link that in the card above. If it's your first time setting up an Etsy shop, you can get 40 free listings with the referral link that's in the description. And when you use that, I also get 40 free listings. So it's sort of a win-win situation. But definitely check out that video first, because all of the stuff in this video kind of assumes that you've already checked out that video. All right, let's get started. Number one, your pictures. When I create a custom listing, I add something in the images to kind of show that it's a custom or personalized design. So let's add a photo. All right, so I'm setting up kind of a fake little listing. This is for custom hand-drawn calligraphy. So my first image is going to say something like your name or your text. Let's go ahead and put this one in. The next image that I usually put into a custom listing is a sample of the design completed so they can kind of get an idea what it looks like. And then sometimes I'll add a second one. I don't think that's really necessary, but just the more examples you have, it'll give people an idea of what they're going to get. Number two, title and description. In the title section, you'll of course want to say hand lettering and calligraphy and that kind of thing, but you'll also want to add the words custom, personalized, and stuff like that. This is a digital file. In the description, you'll want to add text for how exactly this process works. Your text could be something like, you know, when checking out, send me one name. I'll personalize it and get it back to you in 24 hours. And here are the files included, blah, blah, blah. Also in the description, I usually say something to the effect of, you know, you're not going to be getting a physical item. This is for digital files. And then I add my licensing information. I usually allow, you know, personal and small business use up to 100 productions. Number three, personalization section and tags. Etsy also has a personalization section specifically for this. So if we turn this on, you can see some space where you can add some instructions for your buyers. And you can also add character limits here. So I just usually put something like, please send one name, here's the character limit, and then I thank them. And I'll also change the character limit down here. In your tags, you'll also want to add personalized, custom, and words like that. Number four, digital file section. In the digital file section, I usually just add a PNG file or a JPEG that kind of says thank you to them. I also remind them when they can receive their files, and if they have any questions or anything like that, they can just reach out to me. Usually when people order digital files on Etsy, they're available immediately. So in this case, I like to add something here so they can download it and see that, oh yeah, I have to wait for this. Number five, getting the files to your customer. I think most people usually just email the files, but you could also use Google Drive or Dropbox and then give them an access link. I wouldn't really recommend doing it that way though, because you probably need to store their files there forever. And with an email link, they will always have the files in their email. Number six, what to do after an order comes in. Okay, after an order comes in, you'll see a little number one like this in orders and shipping. Then you'll come over here to completed. You'll be able to see the order in there, and you should see the personalization right underneath it. So once you've created all the files and everything, you can click on this little drop down and it'll show you the email address of your customer. Then you can just right click and copy email address, go out to your email account and email the files. Usually after I email the files to their email, I also message them here and let them know that I've sent the files to them. And so those are all the extra things that I do when I'm creating a custom listing on Etsy. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like it, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.